Hey, everyone's Dave here, and welcome to MarineVerse Cup Overview. Funny story, the developer of this game actually reached out to me back in the day to try it out, and it was truly the first opportunity ever I got. If we were including both side quests and the official store, I don't even think the channel had 100 subscribers. It was really a miracle that someone wrote me when I was basically no one. I never took upon that offer. I believe I was coming from the place that I have literally nothing to do with sailing, and not knowing much about VR altogether, it just didn't seem appropriate to do the video about. But it's nice seeing this graduating to the official store just like any project of this kind. So MarineVerse Cup is a sailing racing simulator game where we're being put in boats with other people and set sail on deep waters in the competitive setting. This is definitely something out of my comfort zone. I never in my life had an opportunity to drive yachts or dinghy. I'm kinda getting concerned looking at the trailer because from just the graphics and environment it looks very basic. It doesn't seem to use any photogrammetry, which I would think is like a given for those type of experiences. I can already clock the whole world is covered in the 360 photo, as well as there's not much details going on with the textures or even the surface of the water. Just on the first glance, it doesn't seem to represent the needed quality for the official store. Moreover, the description says if you wanna play in multiplayer, you have to have an additional subscription model added on top of buying the game, which seems very weird practice to me. Maybe it's poorly explained, but it's literally what it says in the Oculus app. If that's really the case, then it's dead on arrival. I'm all for supporting developers and stuff like that, but a double payment just to get multiplayer going on? No, that is surely not happening with me. We'll have to see how the game performs in the gameplay. There's a lot of bizarre decisions and things going on, so I hope everything will clear up eventually. Let's go sailing! Welcome to MarineVerse Cup. Let us show you the ropes. I guess that's a tutorial, right?
Alright, let's get ready for sailing.
Your task is to get to the yacht parked moored at the end of this dock.
To teleport, first point at a teleport location, then press and hold the right trigger until teleported.
So no smooth locomotion. Cool.
Well done.
We can't even teleport to anywhere, just to designated spots.
Well done.
Put the wheel all the way to the left.
Nice. All right. Let's get ready for sailing.
Hi, fish.
First of all, let's make sure the height at which you are sitting is comfortable. Your head should be below the sail, and at the same time, the boat floor level should feel right.
Okay, well, I guess we're sitting down. Sit on the side? Oh my god, hi camera. Oh shit, I think that's it. Hi. Your boat can't sail directly into that direction. To steer, push the right controller thumbstick left or right. That's gonna be interesting.
You are sailing.
Finish the story or sail through all the gates. Wait, do we not steer with this? Oh. I won't touch it for now, I guess.
To go faster, adjust the main sheet to control the sail.
How's faster? Aha, okay. I think I have to pull it constantly.
You are doing very well. Have you sailed before?
No way. It changes. Oh, the city. Wait, is this a pile of trash?
Keep going, you're almost there.
Or is it supposed to be like buildings? Oh wow, it really is complicated. I'm not a sailor, so...
Well done! Let's learn some sailing terms. The big sail on the boat is called the mainsail. Can you find it? Mainsail. Well done. Can you find those?
Dagger boat.
Dagger board.
Boom?
Boom. Delightful.
Tiller?
Main sheet.
Okay, whatever.
Tiller. Well done, my salty dog. Next, you should try some sailing. go back to main menu when you are ready.
Well, that was not that hard, because there were just five things I could pinpoint my controller, so it's only given I'll eventually find out.
Would you like to name this boat?
No.
This is a yacht. A fast racing boat with two sails. A bit harder than the dinghy. In multiplayer, you can operate this boat with friends in the co-op mode.
Oh, okay. Speaking of which, can we actually go to the multiplayer? Here, enter lobby. We have to create an account, but it says next session is in 5 hours. Jesus, really? All this work to just have an access to the multiplayer? Or at least I suppose it's better than just paying for a subscription. That is so weird though. They have to change the description in the Oculus app because it's just misleading to say the least for all the players. Oh my god, and now I will have a pin? Jesus! Hi!
Have you sailed before?
No, this is probably my first time on the boat overall. I did look up the tutorial, so that's cool. Something at least.
Do you see the red zone on your compass?
Mm-hmm.
You can't sail against the wind, so you have to go out of the red zone.
Oh yeah, that makes sense, okay.
Where do you come from?
I'm technically from Poland, but I don't say that because I live in France.
Technically from Poland. So that was the start of the horn. Now we can start. Now just tack in the sails. Yeah, good. And steer towards me. Towards me? To the right? Yeah. Good.
It's kind of hard because the direction of the wind is always in the direction where I should go.
That's how it is. Pull the sheets in. Like, yeah. Stay like that. Don't turn. Just a little bit to the left, to the right. So we hit the mark. Yeah, that's good. Good, good, good. Keep it. Keep it this way. Perfect. We're gonna win this race. Yeah, that's good. Okay, stay there, stay there. So now tack. Now you can turn to the left. Turn hard to the left. Yeah, and then you get to the mark. See it? Pull in the sheets.
Mm-hmm, so you have to kind of maneuver left, right to just gain speed.
Leave the sheets out. Yeah, good, better. Go to the left, to the left, to the left, perfect. Yeah, that's good. That's fast. Now turn left, round the mark. Very good.
On the left side or right side?
On the right side, here.
Oh, there, right.
Like I go. Good. Now steer around the mark. Here. Good.
Okay.
That's good. That's good. Looks good. Now you're fast. Wait, look to the left. Only leave the sheets out. The sheets should be out. Get a little bit more in. You see, right next to the mast, you see a red mark and a green mark. You see that? Sail, you have two like small flags, a red one and a green one.
Oh, yeah.
If the one towards you, like towards the wind, is chilling, you gotta pull in the sails.
That's a good tip.
That's what they are for. If the one behind the sail is killing, is like chilling, you have to let the sails out. If the one on the loose side, on the wind side of the sail is chilling, you have to take in the sails. Good. That's fast. Nice. Come on. That's the finish line here. Oh, you're gonna hit me. No, don't turn. Good.
Oh, now it says go around the buoy and stuff.
Almost, yeah, good. Now when you go downwind, that's called downwind towards the mark too. Because you have the wind in your back. See, then you can leave out the sails. Now it's very much way better. No, I'll leave the sails out. That's fine.
Oh, what?
The bright areas in the water, like the one I'm in right now, there's not that much wind there, so you should avoid them. The darker spots are more wind, so you should look for them. Very nice, Chip. See, in front of us is the darkest spot to the left here. You're fascinated, right?
Hmm. Well, that lap was definitely faster than the previous one. Yeah, those indicators on the flag really help if one's moving or not.
Good, now you're finished, right?
Yeah.
Ah, shit! My legs.
Well, that was definitely an experience. I don't think I'm ready for a yacht tutorial, but if you get a hold of controls and kinda understand what's going on, then the experience is pretty enjoyable. I'm glad that I bumped into someone that helped me. If we're talking about the graphics specifically, don't love them. For Quest 2, you can definitely push more and get rid of this teleporting. I don't see why smooth local should not be enabled. It's hard to say if it feels early access or not. I mean, just looking at the cubes and just UI feels a little bit amateur to me. Though the mechanics are here, so if you're into sailing and know what to do already, then it's fine. The sailing pass was very confusing. It essentially says that Pro League access, not multiplayer altogether, is enabled. So they really should clarify it on the store, because I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one that understood it that way. Altogether is definitely not for me. It's for a very niche audience that's into that stuff, but at least I know how to sail properly now.